Hey everyone, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. Today we are diving into a super useful feature, that is how to upload files directly from your computer to a .NET web API and save them in a folder with just a few clicks in Blazor WebAssembly. Imagine this, you're building an e-commerce application or maybe even a project management tool. You want users to upload files, maybe profile pictures, product images or document directly from their browser. Having a secure and efficient way to handle this upload can make all the difference in your app's user's experience. So in this video, I will show you how you can use a Netcode-Hub file upload component to make it smooth, secure and fast. So stay tuned as we walk through the steps, build the API endpoint and hook it up with the Blazor WebAssembly. If you're enjoying these tips, don't forget to like and subscribe for more .NET and Blazor content right here on the Netcode Hub. So let's hop into it. Make sure you have your Visual Studio 2022 or higher installed. We're going to create a project which is going to contain Blazor WebAssembly and API. So you can see from here, we have our two projects. We have a solution, we have a two projects, client and our server, which is the client is a Blazor WebAssembly standalone. Then we have our server as an API. Let's first go in there and build our API endpoint first. So let's go to controller. So we can update this. So let's now create a method, our endpoint, who is going to accept it, create a folder, and just drop the file in. Very simple. So here, this is what we're doing. We have our file, we get a file. We want to generate file name for the file that is coming in. We don't want to maintain the original file name. So you want to add at least some string characters to it. That's the reason why we generate a good string, then we append it to the file name coming in. So in order to, for us to get the path, we need to use iWeb host environment so we can create a folder as a www folder and then put all our files in there. You can also use iHost environment if you want to locate or place this folder within your solution. You can do it, but mostly in the static files, I want to keep them in the www folder. So that's the reason why I'm using this iWeb host environment. So we need a folder known as images. So here we want to focus on uploading images only, but this is going to apply to all files. Could be PDF, could be images, could be videos, any file at all. So we want to make sure if the directory, the folder that we are talking about, if it doesn't exist, then we're going to create it. So we're going to say that if this upload path, in case you make a search and you couldn't find that, it means it doesn't exist, then kindly go ahead and undo what is needful. So directly.create directly. So we're going to go in there and uncreate it. We have the file name already specified here, so we don't need to specify it. All that we're going to do here is to provide this variable, and that is all. After we are done, we can go ahead and combine the path, and we can now push it or copy it and paste it in there, and that is all. So let's get the file. So once you're done copying, we want to return the address, let's say the address, so that in our API, we can view it in our API, not in our client. that's a Blazor or any other client that you want to create. So in here, we want to return the image URL. And how can we do it? We need to get the image URL from the request or scheme and now the host. And now the folder known as the images, and we want to grab the file. Remember that the file here contains a new name plus the old name, and we get it and return it as a string. Okay, let's go to the program.cs file and add calls and also use HTTP static files. So first of all, we're going to add calls in here. So use calls, we specify we want to allow any header, any method, and any origin so that clients can make requests to it. After we are done, we need to use static files. So we also need to add this. We need to add the wwwroot folder. So go to the server, right click on it. Then let's add new folder, wwwroot. Yeah, so we need this. So we can store all static files in here because we're using static files. And we need to locate a folder where all these files can be. I think I have this package, what can enable us to do it better. That is one of my packages for file upload. So let's go in there and install that package. Normally I do have the package reference, so I'll just unload the project. Then I'll add it here. So the package name is Netcode-Hub packages.component.fileupload. So install that and let's reload. Now we can go ahead to our home component and use this package. Let's clear all this, inject our HTTP client. So Netcode-Hub file upload. So in that we can specify, let's have a reference and we say this is file upload. Aside from that, we can specify notify which is going to return is an event which will return the file that you have selected. And we can also specify required extension. So the extension that you need, we're going to say required extension. So with this, let's go and have the variable for this. So let's create a list of string. So here I want to upload only images. So I'm going to make it in the form of, I need only PNG files. I need also JPG files. So this is what I need. Aside from that, let's create, copy this. Let's create instance of it. Okay. Now once you are done with this, we can go ahead and create a method for this. This should be a void because it gets in the file model, so you need Netcode-Hub file model. You say this is model, and now we can go and check that if we say model dot file model dot iBrowser files dot any. So in case there's any, that is where you want to do this. Now what you want us to do, we want to just upload it straight to the server. So we're going to say that that is a file is equal to, we have our model dot file model dot iBrowser file dot first or default, since this is list. It also supports multiple files, so you can select multiple files as well, but for now you want to focus on uploading just a file in here. So this is what we can do. In case it's not any, then you want to return that. But in case we have at least one in it, then we want to grab that one and pass it on here. Now after we have this, all that we're going to do here is attach to the header and now make a call with it as a post to the API that we have created. How are you going to go about that? Let's first create a content and you stream it. We're going to create a file content. We're going to add a file to the content, and that is so we can make a post with it. Let's do that. So here we're going to make a call. We have our clients. So we're going to be using post async. Let's specify it's an API, and the controller name is file upload. Then we have a route upload. Then let's specify the content. So you can go up and cross check. It's file upload, that is a name, and the route is upload. An API file upload and an upload. And that's why we have API file upload and an upload to pass in our content. And we can check the response. So we can say that if response here is success, then what do you want to do? We want to get the results. So we want to read as read our string async, and here we can say let's have we say image URL. We have our string dot empty. Now let's grab this and we can talk about results. So with this, since we're making an HTTP client call, we need to specify the address. So let's get it straight from the server properties, and you can see we have it in here. So let's grab this and let's go to our home, and then we're going to add it. So after we're done with it, let's go and implement status change so that it can refresh as soon as it gets new request from the response from the API. All right, so that is good. Now let's run this project and check it out. So we can configure startup project and make sure you have the server and the client start apply to give it a new profile. Then let's start it up. So this is our API, this is our client. Now let's focus on this. So let's put a breakpoint here, and now let's select a file. So I have this simple image as a screenshot. Let's click on that. Now a breakpoint might be hit, so let's wait to see. Yeah, that is hit. So let's step over. Now we're going to check. So we check in. Yeah, so we have the model, we have the file selected. We want to grab first, so we have it over here. We create context. That's a multi-part form data content. As soon as you create it, we read the file. You want to get a stream. Then here, we're going to add it to the content. So you can see this is a file type, and then we specify the file content in here. After that, you want to make a call. So the call to this HTTPS, which is a server, and we must make sure that the server is also available. Okay, the file controller, and also the route that we specified. Now, in case it works, you need to return a success. And that is an okay 200, and let's wait and see in case it worked. Okay, so we are not having any response yet, right? Yes, so that is it. Now when we check this, there's a response. Let's click on next, and as soon as it gets in, it means the operation was success, right? Now you're going to read it, so we have the results as a link of the image, and that is it. Now let's assign to this variable which is going to be loaded in the image, and it should get it work. Yeah, we have it. So you can see in a simple terms, we've seen how we can upload image or a file from our client to our server, save it in there. If you want to verify, go to solution, and you can see from your server www root, open it, you can see a folder known as images created, and boom, you have the file over here. So I hope this tutorial has helped you see how you can easily implement file upload in your .NET 8 API. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss out any of my upcoming videos. Until next time, stay safe and see you again.